the adage, it's Onyx time, might be something that BTK will always have to look for because they have to really manage their time well. Any split second that you're wasting against an efficient Onyx PH team, you will lose a majority of the map.
All right, but we're getting ready to enter the draft for game number one. Are you guys ready? Onyx Philippines going in for the two bans already. Yeast and Shin and that Yves. Whereas BTK, they're taking away Kyrie's heroes.
My goodness, I mean, both sides are making sure they're getting the top two most banned heroes out of the way. Yves currently in second place. Hayabusa has overtaken Yves in the most banned hero here currently at M3. But looking back at Onyx PH, they immediately look to get rid of Beatrix, limit down that flexibility of the hero pool.
And if you're looking at BTK, do you ban out the Rafaela this time? Or are you going to take a page out of RQ's book and ban that Selena as it was deadly for Onyx PH? We're not even talking about those crazy last pick coming out from Onyx, like the last pick Natalia, right? That will be surely a thing of consideration for BTK. What I do love about Onyx PH's bans, they really did target BTK. First banning the Yi Sin Shin, making sure that BTK will pick another hero for MOBA Zane.
Absolutely, but let's see. It is going to be the Ling. Three bans towards Kyrie right now for BTK. Onyx Philippines with the response now as the first pick. What is up for grabs? Again, Rafaela is up, but it is going to be the far sub for Hatred first. Ooh. BTK, they have the chance to come here, maybe with a Roger and a Yuzong.
Exactly.
That's what I was thinking as well, because you saw the big smile on MOBA Zane's face. He's realizing that, yes, they are allowing him to gain access to his 100% win rate hero on that Roger. But the question is, they have to be a little careful here. Is this a potential setup? Is this a potential bait? Because teams have been adapting, and the M3 meta so far, the tournament meta so far, continues to grow as the tournament goes by.
Oh, let's see. Oh, it's actually the Esmeralda here picked up for BTK. 46.5% win rate, but Esmeralda has been one of the most safest first picks in this whole tournament. One of the favorites as well. Let's see, for the other pick, do you think it's gonna be Roger and why?
I think it just makes sense to get the Roger right now. Instead they go for the Nidan. Okay, so if actually they haven't been picking it, this will be the first time I will see Nathan from BTK.
Okay, I mean, they went through the NA qualifiers for M3 with Natan on their side. So this is something that MOBA Zane is extremely comfortable with. But let's also keep in mind that every competitor before that BTK has beaten has banned out the Natan.
That's right. Now for Onyx PH, they still have the Matilda as well as the Paquito. Might not be that that inclined to pick up this hero, but you also have the Clint, and Onyx PH really likes that hero for Marky, and it might be the hero to kind of counter this Nathan instead. They pick up the Yuzhong themselves.
This is crazy, the Yuzhong and the Paquito. Now, this is the flex pick for the Paquito. Yuzhong most likely going to go to that XP lane, but Onyx Philippines, it seems like they want to just pull the tempo. They want to get that early lead and snowball from there. But BTK, that is the Lilia pick that's just been so, so good on their side. Picked up 57.1% win rate now, going back to the bans. BTK will have to choose. Do they want to ban more of Kyrie's heroes? Beloisky's heroes. That is going to be the Selena. We'll most likely see a Rafaela ban next.
Or maybe the Natalia, right?
I think they should ban the Natalia, pick up the Roth for themselves, because at this point, it's going to be Yuzhong looking to try and shut down Natan as he's going to be roaming around, and Natan even wants to actually get the cancel on that Feather Airstrike. Either they double down on their disengage mechanics or look for something that can actually knock away the Feathered Airstrike.
Yeah, because if you think about it, BTK have not lost with the Rafaela, so that might be a good pickup for BTK. Kind of makes me think Onyx PH should also ban that out. I mean, they're the second pick in the second phase. That means that they need to take this away, because I'm sure that BTK, at moment's notice, they're going to get that hero. It has great combination with the Nathan as well as the Esmeralda, so it just makes total sense to ban another fella here.
Your team is banning.
It will be them to ban it out.
There you go. BTK going for the Raph and the Selena ban, but like you mentioned, I do agree with your statement, actually. Natalia poses a bigger threat than the Rafaela in this composition. BTK with the Natan is going to be really, really susceptible to those kind of early invades, but let's see what they pick up for themselves. They can still go perhaps for something like the Florin, for something like the just the healers that can help Natan get through that early phase.
They picked up Grok with Shark before. By the way, this is an interesting stat. 100% win rate for Lolita on Shark.
Ooh.
Wow.
That's really, I didn't notice it.
Honestly, I think Shark is just one of the more underrated players coming in from BTK, and I think people need to give him that respect. Kufra, wow. High risk, high reward here with a lot of heal potential. I was thinking maybe what Wolf said, going with the Grok to kind of use the barrier to cancel out the Feathered Airstrike, but instead, they just want the full engagement. That's going to be Natalia. That's also going to be the Kimmy coming from Onyx PH, the banana split. Ooh, it's going to be good.
I like it so far for both of the teams. You know, Onyx Philippines, they have their straight up composition here. They want to play it a little bit front to back, but also a little bit of a dive, but also front to back. But BTK, what are they going to finish it off with? It is the Brody for Fried Chicken. What are your thoughts on the draft? But firstly, that Kufra, because this is the first time that we're going to be seeing Shark play it.
Yeah, it's actually the second time, but the first time they lost with it. So I agree with you, Mirko. This is a questionable pick in a way. That's what also Gideon mentioned about, what about the Grok going to be a better solution? But instead they go for it. Maybe they have prepared for this. One thing that I always want to say about BTK is that they have these pocket strategies that they prepare against opponents. And you know what time it is?
It's Onyx time, perhaps. But we are going to get into the portal here. Gideon, I want some quick predictions on the draft.
Honestly, I think this draft is pretty 50-50 on either side here. It's going to be about clean mechanics and, most importantly, how the supports make that big impact this game to really crack things open. Because Natalia, so heavily snowball oriented, but if the peel coming in from Kufra is going to be more than enough, this might be BTK's game.
Well, let's see how it goes here. It is gonna all come down to the execution. Suntech, make some noise. Game number one is on the way for the upper bracket finals. BTK going up against Onyx PH.
Game's already begun here, and the lane assignment's very clean. Nothing too out of the ordinary. Most importantly, we need to keep our eyes on where is Natalia going to strike first. Does she want to go immediately into enemy territory by the jungle? Oh, BTK, they've already have the setup for it to make sure that all the exits are going to, sorry, all the entry points to the jungle is covered.
Yeah, not just the entry point, but also securing that little wanderer. Very, very huge for BTK here in the early game, but they need to be careful. BTK, they need to understand that MOBA Zayn can't really do anything until that level 4 power spike. Well, look at this, Boyski already doing so much damage. Zia is going to get taken down by Hatred. An amazing first blood by Razor from Onyx Philippines.
They just flicker onto Hatred into the BTK lineup in front of the Kufra as well as the Lilia. How crazy is that?
Wait, they find another kill on that bottom side. Fried Chicken is winning his matchup.
You can see the flicker was actually really, really good for the side of Fried Chicken. Marky kind of panicked a little bit in that last moment, and the Kufra was able to capitalize. But so far, it is still better for the side of Onyx Philippines. Remember, the kill was taken by Hatred. Meanwhile, BTK, it was taken by Shark.
I love the order of picks from BTK because they picked up the lane at first, thinking Onyx PH thinking that it will be in the gold lane for Fire Chicken. They switch it up. They went for the Kimmy so that it will have a better lane against the Nanen. But this time Brody versus Kimmy, it's very 50-50. You can even say that it might be Brody sided.
Yeah, honestly, but wait a minute. Beloyski needs to be careful. You can't really jump into that. They will back away, but this turtle, who has pressure on it? Right now, it's BTK.
I mean, they're struggling to get pressure because the most important thing for BTK is keep in mind that Beloyski is going to be in the stealth form. The moment they know his position, they have much more of an understanding on where they want to start positioning themselves on the map and, more importantly, protecting their backline.
Okay, Kyrie going to start this turtle up. Shark opening up the map right now, but it's going to be Beloyski right there going up onto Zia. Black Dragon form to zone them away as Beloyski is just going to use that to zone and take the turtle from BTK. Onyx picks up the first turtle of the game. Passion made possible by the Singapore Tourism Board.
Now, looking at how the way BTK is playing, they don't mind sacrificing these neutral objectives because they scale at the end of the day. They're going to have supreme scaling, in matter of fact, with both of their marksmen on their side. And even Zia being able to keep up with them, it's going to be tough because Kyrie will start to eventually fall off.
Yeah, I do agree with that, especially with Akimi. If you don't get turrets after the first few minutes of the game, you're going to be struggling when it comes to dealing the damage. And it is true for Onyx Philippines, they're kind of all in the early game. For BTK, if they just sit back and relax, just farm it out, make sure that their lanes are managed, maybe they can take us to the late game with better arsenal compared to Onyx PH.
Yeah, honestly, right now it's going to be a very, very interesting dynamic because BTK, they're playing it really, really safe. And look at the pathing coming in from BTK. MOBA Zayn always on the opposite side of Kyrie. This is amazing.
Yep, it's really, really good here because the most important thing is to protect that Brody lane. They want to play generally down towards that bottom side and make sure that Brody doesn't get punished because it's hard to hurt Esmeralda overall.
We can see right now, Hatred popping in the Feather Airstrike to be able to zone away. But people from the mid lane, Veloyski, will be able to chunk MOBA Zayn a little bit as Hatred, again, doesn't have the Feather Airstrike, can't really contest, can't really poke him a little bit anymore. But Kyrie and Onyx, they're waiting for something here.
No, this is good. They're waiting for BTK to make that first mistake here. Shark going for a big setup overall, but you can tell that BTK making sure they are... Oh, hold on.
Oh, Black Shoes actually popped Kyrie. Amazing, amazing read right there, but Onyx Peach still only in the 200 gold lead. Yep.
Little bit of pressure for bottom lane. This would be good for BTK.
Oh, Marky's got to be careful. We'll be able to get the vision. Oh, Shark! Ooh. What was that? Tyrus Revenge and the Flicker out of nowhere. Didn't even expect it. Marky still has the Flicker.
Beautiful, beautiful Flicker into Tyrant's Rage there. Because every time you see it, you never really can react to the overall Flicker mechanic. It just happens so fast and you think, man, it looks like someone's trolling Tyrant Rage in a weird direction, suddenly flickering on top of you. Good play coming in from Shark.
Oh, wonderful play. Now, on a PH, their answer is to get the neutral objectives. For BTK, they have snatched the lead back to their side, and taking down the outer turret energy shields in the bottom lane is going to be big for White Chicken. The kills that they were getting onto Marky, 0 and 2 for now, is going good for BTK because it means that you're stopping the snowball off of Kimmy.
Absolutely. This is the thing right now. BTK, they're just scaling at this point, right? They're not looking for fights. They're only looking for picks all over the map. And right now, they're playing their lane matchups really, really well. Ooh. The Kimmy hasn't been able to do anything in that gold lane, but wait a minute, Kyrie going in very aggressively onto MOBA Zayn, and that is going to be him still trying to run away. No way! MOBA Zayn, he's finally going to get taken down as Kyrie looks for a double kill right there. Jalarski will be the one picking up. Zia now trying to get away, but the Black Shoes, he's only going to be taken back to where he's from. That's going to be the Tyrus Revenge connecting onto Jalarski, knocking them back and securing that peel for BTK, but it is a 2-0 trade.
It was a good adaption coming in from Onyx PH. They had a solid read that he would be on towards the top side of the map, and now, most importantly, they have the scouting Veloyski. He's really playing with fire.
Oh, Shark going in for the Tyrant's Rage, and that's going to be the torn apart memory to pick up the kill, equalizing once more BTK.
Oh, Shark really is a game changer for BTK. So far has been there for 3 kills of BTK. In fact, he got 2 because of his initiations and that counterplay allowing White Chicken to get another kill this time on Veloyski. This is amazing for BTK. And the lead that Onyx PH at 830 gold, this is not what you want if you're just looking at their lineup. In fact, BTK, despite them struggling a little bit, this is actually pretty good for the team.
Has been destroyed. How good can it get though? They want to start pressing their leads. They're pushing it on towards that top side. Yes, turtles are falling into Onyx PH's side, but one bad fight could really turn the favorites into BTK.
This is not good for the side of Onyx Philippines, honestly, right? They need more than just 300 gold. The Veloyski going in on to White Chicken. That's got a lot of damage placed, but the amazing flicker and the bouncing ball at the right moment will be able to ensure his safety. Again, Onyx PH, they've been in control of these turtles, but right now it is only a 700 gold lead built up.
Man, Veloyski, he's such a team player. He did not want to use his execute. He really wanted to get the kill.
Oh, wait a minute. Shark is going to get caught, and that's going to be him taken down right there. Tyrant's Revenge unable to connect as Jalarski will be able to zone 4 members away. Kyrie picking up the turtle the third time in this game.
It's good. It's so good. And awkward timing, yes, of course, that we wanted to see Onyx PH really start pushing, putting some gas onto this fire, but they've already started the ignition.
Oh, look at that. Veloyski needs to be careful. White Chicken able to get the stun. Torn of our memory as well. He's still able to get out, but that is amazing from White Chicken. The fact that he is able to withstand this damage most probably is because of those items.
I love the fact that Onyx PH actually went into Shark and really punished him. That guy has been the problem for Onyx PH because when they want to go for the jump, Shark is always there for the counter initiation play. And they went and burst this Kufra. This means that Onyx PH will have a lot of priority onto this hero. But Kufra already has got the Athena shield perfect against Onyx PH.
Onyx PhD might be looking for an engage here. Entropy being used by MobaZane, dealing some damage, but Beloisky will be able to bait away the Black Shoes. Beloisky's gonna get bursted down by the airstrike by Hatred. Picks up a kill on the other side. MobaZane, two times already picked off in this game.
Wow, wow. Good flicker coming in from Hatred here. Beloisky with a good read. Most importantly, understanding he will die, but he will bait out this fight. Oh. Nicely done by Onyx PhD.
It's always the alley-oop coming up from Beloisky. Not scared of dying. All he has to do is to deal the damage, and eventually Hatred will force that. Because BTK, the way that they're saving their teammates is that they group up together. And it makes total sense for this Farsa to just use and pop that ultimate. And eventually Onyx PhD will go for the cleanup. This time, Hatred is on the mark, especially with that flicker play.
Right now, as it seems, Onyx PhD building up that 2,000 gold lead, and the Kimi is scaling very, very well. Let's see Shark going in, Tyrant's Rage, unable to connect. It is going to be them going for the re-engage for the airstrike to dock. Shark down right now. Zlarky dives the back line. Beloisky picks up the kill. MobaZane has nowhere to go. Marky gets another, and MobaZane will die for the third time in this game. BTK looking for something though. Turn up on memory, almost taking Marky down. Now Victor going in onto the backside. Let's see if he can do anything. He's going to get stunned up. Onyx Philippines with the amazing. Amazing front to back, will be able to win it out. Zia popping in Black Shoes as White Chicken. Kyrie, look at him! What the heck was that? Kyrie and Hatred, the dynamic duo, getting it done 4-0.
Oh my god. Hatred!
Hatred, man.
If he doesn't get MVP, I'm going to be very upset. He is making everything happen. Let's look at this replay one more time and just break it down, because overall, this fight is all about being able to peel. Hatred is able to get the stun at the right moment. And it helps that Marky first item Ice Queen's one.
Look at Kyrie.
His lane.
Okay. Where you go, you shall not pass, says Kyrie. Man. And Hatred just the icing on the top. Everybody is on point from Onyx PhD. I think that they really turned it up. And the fact that they're coordinating all their skills, that might be the Onyx magic that we're looking for. Hatred with the stuns really stopping Victor from his tracks. And that wasn't the only time he did that stun. He actually stunned MobaZane so that Dilarski will be able to catch up. And boy, Onyx PhD eventually gets the snowball. 5,000 gold lead for themselves now.
That really felt like a video game, man. BTK, yeah. they were about to lose, already losing, backing away. Then the final boss appears out of nowhere, catching him. Literally just standing there too. Look at Kyrie opening up the map with that jab. It's just going to be so good for them. This map pressure is so good for Onyx Philippines. Look at how they're able to control the map. And Shark, he's unable to do anything here because of that vision.
I mean, it's fine for now. BTK, understand, if they have one turnaround fight, the gold evens out and it goes back to a neutral state. But for Onyx PhD, they just need to manage their ways. Look at how they're doing it.
This Natalia coming out from Beloisky is starting to be a lot of problem for BTK, and maybe for the next teams that will face Onyx PhD, or maybe the next few games, because this has been a championship hero for Beloisky.
Oh, for the airstrike, almost taking him down, as that's going to be BTK forced to back away from their tier 2. Lord marching down again here in that top side. It is going to be Kyrie and Beloisky trying to do the same onto the mid and the bottom side. Beloisky on that Natalia will pick up the tier 2 in the bottom side, building up to a 6.7 now, 1,000 gold lead.
I'm so curious what Hatred's items is right now. I just saw him get the Winter Truncheon. I'm not sure if it's third or second, but look at that damage. I'm guessing it's probably his third.
Oh my god, beautiful movements and beautiful poke. As Beloisky is going to dive onto MobaZane, that's a little bit too aggressive. He's going to get picked up, but it's all going to be worth it. It bought so much time for Onyx. The banana split coming in. What time is it? It's Onyx time.
How beautiful that was that. I mean, Beloisky didn't even get the kill, but they still got a push.
Oh my god, look at the engage coming from Shark. Able to get Dilarski there, but it's going to be Hatred popping in for the airstrike. Now Fight Chicken jumping in with a torn up on memory. The Winter's Truncheon saves him once more as they're going to go for the turn. Zia popping in with Black Shoes, still able to run away for now, but it's going to be Marky chasing him down, taking him down. Killing speed picked up as that is a 2-4-0. The fact of the matter is, BTK, they are unable to get even a single kill on the board.
It's the timing, it's the item power spikes coming in from Onyx PhD. The situational items are really getting a lot of value to help them press their lead.
I agree with that, because of the fact that Winter Truncheon really bought so much time, and BTK, they were so into getting down, taking down Hatred, and they're really just so focused in that. They're tunneling into that vision of trying to shut down Hatred. Even with a jump coming out from Victor, wasn't able to stop Hatred from popping the ultimate. In fact, Hatred Truncheon stayed in front of Victor for quite a long time before popping that Winter Truncheon in the most perfect moment where BTK was already so overcommitted.
At this point, you can call him the Winter King, man, because that is the plays that he's able to do in the world stage constantly against RRQ and now against BTK. Onyx pushing the pace with the 7,000 gold lead, manipulating those waves, waiting for the Lord.
Still, if you're looking at BTK, still have to look at their scaling. For Onyx PH, it's true that their split push has been doing well. They have been getting this macro lead and they have been snowballing. But you'd never ever have to underestimate the scaling of both the Nadan as well as the Brody. They still will be stronger when the gold is even. Maybe around the 20-minute mark when everything is just equalized. BTK, as long as they hang on to their base, this is still winnable for them.
I mean, this is going to be nerve-wracking, especially for Fly Chicken. He went to optimally build very defensively, getting two early defensive item components in the Juggernaut armor, making sure that he could survive. But he's only got a Blade of Despair right now, and he needs way more damage. He understands that he's going to get an item power spike later on. They just need to survive through this onslaught.
Oh man, that feather airstrike. Oh my god! They keep doing this. Beloisky, his positioning is immaculate. The brilliant display of the banana split once again for Onyx.
My god, the coordination between Hatred and Beloisky has been phenomenal. For the longest time, Onyx PH has been playing with Beloisky in the mid lane role, but this time Hatred shining with his mages.
Oh my god, for the airstrike, able to take free chicken so low, but Beloisky! What is this? He keeps getting the kills. Kyrie jumping to the backside, able to zone Victor and Shark away from the turrets, but that is all they need, man. Just one by one taking it, and now the Lord, Enhanced Lord, spawns.
Yeah. Oh my goodness, they're pressing their advantage, and most importantly, we see the numbers 15-5, 10k gold lead, 14 minutes into the game. In situations like this, they've got about 3 minutes to survive for BTK.
Beloisky is the name of the game. He's gonna go back in. Victor's gonna be chased, and the Shark Man will try to go for more, but he's gonna get taken down, boxed away. Look at Victor, he's trying to save the game, but the base will simply be targeted, and Onyx PH will reign supreme in game one.
Oh my goodness, Beloisky to Hatred. That's an alley-oop once again. So many times it happened in this game. And look at the face of the guy. Game face on. Hatred is angry and he's not gonna stop. Look at the confidence from these guys. Snowballing through. The multitasking from Onyx PH is a treat to watch. You see them just trying to get a kill. Also while taking the Lord, also while split pushing. Man. The split push is real.
It really is. It was a very clean game. And once again, checkmate coming in from Onyx. Once they started progressing their lead, the moment they hit five, they understood they had a good situational item to bait out that fight. That's when they put the final nail in the coffin. Well done for Onyx, if Onyx Philippines. It's just, what else can you really say about that?
Wow. What I can say is you need to ban away the Natalia. You can kind of say, this was exactly what you said in the draft. Ban the Natalia, the Rafaela was not a threat to their composition. This Natalia is huge, considering that they have two marksmen. Very easy. But look at that, the Filipinos. Let's go, man. They are proud. They are supporting. What time is it? It's Onyx time. There you go, man. But you can see the crowd, the players are happy. BTK will need to go back to the drawing board, and it's time for Leo and LaFell to break it down.
Break it down, we will. Thank you so much to the boys at the desk, Miracle Wolf and Gideon Q. At your service, my name is Leo, joined here by LaFell, and for the first time in a while, BTK has been put on their behind.
Ah, that was so satisfying. Anyways,